by the leaders of the council all the time, and somehow they missed some of the point. I'm grateful that the people in the group report don't know what they're thought, but I'm not yet convinced that everything is beautiful in the garden. I appreciate the members saying they're not complacent, but I think it is a bit early for us to be passing a resolution that says we're proud of what has been a huge improvement. I appreciate that there are places in different parts of the country, about three of them, where a process has been tried with government, not the LGA, and has not made progress. There are very few examples of the kind of intensive work done here, and very little to compare with. So I don't wish to be chairish, but I still have my doubts, and therefore cannot support the very kind offer of the deputy leader of the council, and still wish to continue as I suggested.
Well, sir, if you'd like to say.
Yeah, thanks, Mr. Mayor. I really don't want to elaborate on the point today, but can I, Mr. Mayor, just first of all add my thanks to George Redfern, who's been the independent chair of the group of all, and other members of the board. But can I particularly thank my deputy, Anne Batman, who's been the portfolio for the fantastic leadership that you've given to this agenda. And I think, you know, you've made a major contribution to the improvement journey. I think, just to pick up the point that Phil Gilchrist made, I don't think by any measure we're saying that everything in the garden is done and the job's been done. Paragraph 2, I think, just makes the factual statement that we are the quickest turnaround, I believe, that any council in similar measures has achieved. However, we recognise there's a great deal left to do, and we're not complacent, so I think it's just stating the blindingly obvious, really. So I just want to say that I do believe that this sector-led improvement model that we've piloted, I think we've been the first authority to pilot, has been successful. The LGA see it as successful. But we clearly can't rest on our laurels, and I certainly want us to, you know, work tirelessly to become a high-performing council. But can I just say, it may seem quite unusual to say this, but can I actually thank Jeff Green?
Of course you can. Tom
Harney, the previous leader of London, and that's Phil Gilchrist, the current leader, for the role that you played in our improvement. I think it would be churlish not to do that.
Good
and
effort.
You've probably also the leadership election manager. My one regret, Mr. Mayor, is that I'm assuming more seriously. I do believe that over the past 12 months, my group has made a genuine attempt to reach out to members from other parties to engage in the various visioning events. And I think it's regrettable that the party opposite, for whatever reason, has chosen not to engage. Even, Mr. Mayor, even the corporate man seminar the other day had three members of the Liberal Democrats, which is over half their group. So that was great. But I do sincerely ask the party opposite to rethink their non-participation in particular events. For my part, Mr. Mayor, I will continue to offer all members the opportunity to influence our improvement journey and take part in debates about the future of this council. But delighted to second this motion, and I'm sure it will be carried unanimously.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. There is also a lack of personal accountability.
refer to certain new members of the council, particularly newer members. I don't doubt their sincerity, I don't doubt their sincerity in wishing that council becomes an outstanding council. However, some longer established councillors are going to take some time to be convinced that Wirral Council is on the right track and is going to be willing to keep on the right track, and that lessons have been learned by those who got us into the mess in the first place. Labour encourage members to fully engage in the policy and performance committees and visiting events. The committees, I believe, are far too big, particularly the Family and Wellbeing Committee, and have far too wide an area of responsibility to allow full engagement in monitoring what is going on in various service areas. The scrutiny reviews which have been undertaken have been interesting and very worthwhile. Hopefully they will influence future policy making. However, to be done properly, they are very time consuming. In the meantime, the ongoing work of the council is not, in my opinion, being properly monitored. The need for much more improvement is necessary. It must not be forgotten that council exists to serve the people of Wirral. It is so easy to get bogged down with policies and procedures, but if they are not in the best interest, if they are not in the best interest of the people that they represent, they are not worth the paper that they are written on. And of course, Mr. Mayor, we must always consider the well-being of staff and ensure that they are treated fairly through this period of ongoing change, so that we can all work together for everyone's mutual benefit. I would say to the administration, good try, but could do better, and we look for more improvement for when the improvement board come back and see what has actually been achieved. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
All those in favour of the Democrats, ma'am, please show. All those against? That was lost 26-37. Substantive motion, all those in favour. Thank you.
items to be dealt with this evening, four items